What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. So I've been a little MIA for various reasons. Let's not go into it in this video. Anyway, I've just been taking it a little bit easy. And if you follow me on my channels and you know a little bit about my life, then you'll know about Mr. Minners. He has unfortunately become diabetic as well. So we've been dealing with that on top of his other issues already. So send my sweet big gray baby some love. He's going through it, but we're getting through it and we're taking care of it. So I'm back and I am filming my BoxyCharm for July. Feels weird to say July, although it's already the 5th. I'm a little bit behind. Packages didn't arrive quite as early. I just got my Ipsy in the mail today, so I'll be doing that one next. Anyway, let's go ahead and get into it. I've got the BoxyCharm base box. This is $27.99 a month and up to a $260 value. So I've been doing try-ons. I'm gonna keep those up since you guys seem to like those a little bit better. Happy to do that. This box, because I always take a peek and see like, okay, what steps am I doing with the products in my box? This box is kind of random in my opinion, but let's go ahead and get into it. First off, I got something. Now I have tried this fairly recently. I'm not gonna open another one of these. This is actually gonna go in my extras drawer. I do like the product a lot. This is the Kate Somerville Goat Milk Moisturizing Cream. Very on theme today with all the purple. I do like this. It's a thin, creamy consistency. Almost very like liquidy, but feels great on the skin, especially if you do have sensitive skin. That's what it looks like. So I will either save this for a giveaway or give it to someone. I think I have a couple of these. So this goes for $76. It's safe for sensitive skin, gentle enough for all skin types. It's a nourishing cream. It says it has moisture boosting, visible redness reducing ingredients known to soothe dry, tight skin. So I like this product. The price tag is a little bit high, but I think it is a quality product. I'm not gonna try this on. I've tried this on in multiple videos, I believe. Like I said, I like it. It's a moisturizer. There's not much to see when you put it on. I mean, it massages right in. So I didn't feel like we needed a big, long try-on of that. If I didn't already have it, I'd be happy to get it. The next product also, I'm not gonna try on because this is a product that I'm gonna test slowly. So this is by Dr. Lily Fan. It's the probiotic X lash enhancer. So I have tried multiple lash enhancing lash growth products. It says this one goes for $68. That's pretty much median price range. I've tried some that are less expensive and more expensive. Personally, I've used Grande and Velour that I can use on my eyes without a lot of irritation and seem to actually work. I am terrible with consistency of lash products. Don't ask me why. I do a skincare routine every night, but for some reason, the extra step of doing a lash serum, my brain just doesn't get all the way there. So if I can ever train myself to put it on regularly, it does work. Now it says you can put this on anytime and allow it to dry and don't rinse for at least 2 to 3 hours, but it does say for optimal use to apply it at night. I will say this, I looked at the brush. The brush is pretty big and it's all messed up too. I don't know how to put this, but it's like, it's imperfect. It's kind of like weird. Does that really matter? Probably not. I don't like how big this brush is though. The Grande one is much tinier and still I feel like it's quite easy to overdo it because you really only want it right on that lash line. So putting it anywhere else, you're just wasting product. I feel like this would be easy to waste product. Ooh, of all things, why? It doesn't list any fragrance as like an ingredient, so it must just smell like some of the components, but it smells horrible. it smells like a bad medicinal mature smelling fragrance, and that's really weird. I'm not impressed with the brush, the smell, and I'm just afraid this would be irritating. So I'm gonna save this for a night when I'm not going to be putting on makeup the next day. That way, just in case if there's any irritation, I can discontinue it. So we'll see. It might be good, it might not. I'm just not thrilled, you know? Let me get a little sip. The next three items, I'm gonna sound so awful in this video, but this is not the box for me. The last couple boxes I got, I feel like I've been really happy with the majority of everything, but this mixture just isn't doing it for me. I'm sorry, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you what the products are, and these three we are going to try on. So first up, we got the Eloise Luxury Eyeshadow Brush Set. Wow, I'm gonna sound so nitpicky in this video, but I feel like the word luxury is thrown out a little bit too much. This brush set goes for $22 and it's 4 eye brushes. It says, create any gorgeous look with this Prism Luxury Eyeshadow Brush Set. It has 4 essential brushes that help you blend with precision, perfect and enhance any eyeshadow look from subtle to glam, and it's made with super soft synthetic fibers, sleek and sturdy holographic prism handle. Okay, let's take these out. They do look pretty. The handles feel incredibly cheap. I'm just gonna say it because they are this like prism look. Now they're very pretty. They are like the cheapest plastic. Does that really matter? Probably to most people, no. Personally, I like a good weight to a handle. This one's a Sigma brush. It's weighted, it's already balanced. I can use these brushes and get a good eye look. I'm not worried about that, but there's something about a nice brush that you just simply do not feel with these. They're very ferrule heavy because this is such a lightweight plastic. So we have 4 brushes. It looks like a nice shader brush. We've got like an angled brush. There's not a big blending brush, but I have plenty of those, so I'm not worried about that. The bristles do feel very, very soft. I don't always think that the softest brushes are the best though. Personally, the brushes that I like the most are not entirely soft. They have a little bit of texture to them. Just using this one as an example, there's texture. This is very, very soft. And I feel like with this type of a bristle, it tends to apply a lot of product. So if I picked up the same amount of shadow on a better quality brush and this brush, this is going to really lay it down and kind of like maybe pack a little bit too much on. And I don't know, it's just not as customizable. But like I said, we can make it work. I would just suggest loading less product onto your brush, if that makes sense. At any rate, these are the brushes. Very pretty. They have like this prism holographic prismatic. And then we do have an eyeshadow palette to go with it. This is the Necessity eyeshadow palette from Phase Zero. I have tried something from this brand. I'm just gonna be honest, it was not memorable because I just don't remember. So this is a very plain packaging. I've talked about this before. There is nothing wrong with using a plain packaging. Some people will think that this is very chic and sleek. I think it lacks imagination, but then again, it is a sturdier material than like a paper-backed palette, if that makes sense. So to each their own. And this is very, very brown and just not exciting to me in the slightest. I'm gonna try it on for you guys so I can show you some kind of a look with it. It says this goes for $40. It has 8 universal mattes that are buildable. They deliver smooth, highly blendable color designed to create a soft, blended look. It says these are 8 universal matte shadows. Some of these are very soft, almost satin. Maybe they're just saying matte because they're not, you know, glitters, metallics, anything like that, but definitely very satin finish. I'm just gonna pack on some P. Louise base. I always start with this, so to be fair, to give this eyeshadow palette a really good chance, I'm gonna use my favorite primer. Sorry, I am not more enthusiastic about this box, but you know, sometimes that's just how it goes. Do I go with brown or brown? This brush seems like a little packing brush. Okay, so I'm just gonna go in with the darkest brown, which is this one right here. We're gonna go ahead and create a little depth. And, oh yeah, I picked up a lot of shadow. Pigmented, okay. Like I said, this type of bristle, to me, really packs the shadow on more. That may be a good thing for some people. I just think that sometimes it can do a little bit too much. And I'm gonna go ahead and darken the outer corner as well as the crease. This brush is kind of like a little slanted. I assume it'll blend okay. Not bad. All things considered, it's performing well so far. I'm gonna pick up this peachy shade. It's kind of like a peachy nude brown. can't tell you how boring I find this, but we're going with it. I know a lot of people love neutral looks and may be like, girl, that is not boring. I wear neutral every day. I think neutrals are beautiful on most people, but it's just personal preference for myself that I'm not crazy about them. But I see other people wearing beautiful neutral looks and I think they look gorgeous. I think it's a great way to look pretty. If that's what you're looking for, you want your makeup to look nice and put together, or for professional, for work, I totally get it. You want to keep it kind of simple. There's so many reasons to wear neutral looks, but it's just not my favorite. I really don't love this. It's not really blending out. Like, the first shade did fine, but now that I'm trying to blend and kind of meld the colors together, I'm not crazy about it. I'm gonna try this slightly lighter shade. It's only slightly lighter than our first one, but it seems a bit more neutral. So I'm gonna try to add that in and see if I can blend a bit better. I'm having to add a lot of shadow to blend. Usually, I don't add a lot until it's already like semi-blended, but with this, you're gonna need to like actually add shadow to blend it upwards. It's not really like picking up and moving the way that I would usually like. Now that I've added some shadow, it's blending much nicer. So I'm gonna take the lighter shade a little bit and just soften and blur. It's coming out pretty now. It's just a little bit extra work. I think I'm gonna add some base to my lid because I don't think these satiny ones are really gonna stick with I kind of want to go for this one. Okay, that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna do the under lower lash line a little. All right, I added some blue liner just to pep things up a little bit. I'm just gonna go ahead and dive into the last product and then we'll talk about it. This is from Beauty For Certain. And it looks like it is a mascara. This goes for $32. Volume boosting, lash doubling, instant enhancing. I put on my mascara just to go to the bodega. I'm looking for information on this brand because I've never heard of it before. How do I not know who Bia is? Anyway, this looks like it's her brand. So it's for everyday men and women, all skin tones, any age. Part Savage, Extra Energy, Luxe Lightweight Texture to Saucy Shades. So this is a mascara. That's what it looks like. $32 is definitely a high price to me for a mascara because there's so many good affordable ones out there. I don't really buy high-end mascaras. It looks like this is a tubing mascara. And you use micellar water or an oil-based cleanser to remove. I'm going to curl my lashes. My lashes are super straight, super short, all that jazz. I tried this Chella eyeliner that I got in a subscription box. It is terrible. It came off just from touching the eyelash curler to my lid. Anyway, let's try it out. Looks like it has an hourglass wand, which I do like. I like that type of a brush. I usually don't try to get tubing mascaras because I think they get a little bit messy in my opinion. It's not really giving me anything that I like. It definitely feels like my lashes are weighted down. That's about as good as it's getting with one coat. It's getting messy. I don't like to apply a lot of layers of mascara. And it's already transferring. It's getting everywhere. It is transferring under my lash line. Hell no. $32 for that? Absolutely not. Okay, I'm just gonna grab a different mascara for my lower lashes because it's already transferring and I know it's gonna get hella messy if I put that mascara on my lower lashes. If a mascara is not easy, I don't care to work with it, you know, like if it should just work. I can go get a $5, $6, $8, $12 tube of mascara and be much happier than I am right now. So that goes without saying that I do not like this. I do not think this is good. No, this is not it. For $32, I would never recommend that. Let's talk about the rest. The eyeshadow palette is very dusty. It blends okay, but you really have to pack a lot of shadow on there. So it's relatively pigmented, but this definitely did not impress me. To me, if you're gonna come out with a basic eyeshadow palette like this, something very, very neutral, very basic, it needs to be really good quality. Otherwise, what is the point with so many neutral eyeshadow palettes out there? If it's not great quality, then what is the point of it? To me, when I look at eyeshadow palettes, I am either looking for the amazing eye-catching color story that I'm going to be really impressed with and be creative with, or if it's something like this, I want the quality to be really, really good. The brushes, these are all right. They are definitely not my favorite. They actually kind of remind me of some brushes I got off Wish years ago, and I never used them because they just weren't good. But I don't know, these are a little better than that. I just feel like you can tell when something is a dime a dozen type of product. I believe I've gotten an eyeshadow palette from this brand that I thought was decent, but I see a lot of brands pop up and I feel like they're populating their lines with all of these generic products. I haven't tried the whole line, so I can't speak to that, of course, but I see it a lot. I feel like the quality is very generic. There's nothing astonishing about it. It kind of looks similar to something you've seen a lot. Just buying like these mass-produced products and putting their name on it. I will never be into that because it's not unique. The quality is never going to be, you know, that of a well thought out and created brand that really has a vision and they're striving for like amazing quality. It's never going to be the same. So these are really, I'm sorry, this is a very disappointing box. Truly the only thing I am excited about is this, and I already own it. So I do think it's a great product to get. So I would be excited for anyone who gets this, but the rest of it, I am just, this was the biggest miss of a box that I've gotten in a very long time. I am not impressed. So, you know, you guys know this was sent to me, but I'm gonna keep it very real with you and let you know if I don't enjoy something. And I feel like this was a big miss of a box. It is just not for me. As I always say, usually I'm very happy. I feel like last month I really enjoyed everything. So you're bound to have the, you know, an off month or so. So yeah. I can't really see any of these products entering into any type of routine. I can't even imagine picking up the eyeshadow palette or the brushes again, not when I compare them to higher quality products that I own. So I'm sorry that this was a downer, and you know, sometimes it's just like that. So I'm gonna go finish off my look. I'm filming a couple of TikToks. You'll see one about my base, trying a new foundation, and I'm gonna try on some blush and some gloss and things like that. So I hope you guys enjoyed despite the negative outcome. You know, I'm not bashing, it's just not for me. So if you like any of these products, that is 100% fine. You do not have to agree with me, but you know, I gotta keep it real and tell you what I really think. So that's it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Leave me a thumbs up if you like these unboxing slash try on videos, and I will continue to do them for you. That way you get a little bit more meat in the video and not just a, here you go. Also, quickly to mention the value of the box. So this is a $238 value. I personally would not spend $23.80 on this. I'm sorry, it's just not for me. Actually, I would pay that for the moisturizer, obviously. But yeah, you got your dollar amount wise, but I would never recommend any of these products apart from the moisturizer to you in good conscience. So yeah, okay, I'm gone. Thank you again, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.